We've been around so long, they see the errors and they go, oh, it's McDonald's. So when McDonald's went to Mexico, and the first year we opened was 1985, okay? So they'd been open a few years before I got there. And I remember asking the PR person, what did the Mexicans, the locals think when McDonald's opened up in Mexico? Nothing to do with food. It was America. They wanted to go visit America. That's why they went. He said it took 3 or 4 years for them to understand we had Big Macs and French fries and milkshakes and all that. They just wanted to go see what this thing was all about. And then I'll give you the flip side of that, is why you don't play with the menu. When I was in Mexico, the locals said, Bill, we need to have a guacamole burger. I said, a guacamole burger? I said, what is a guacamole burger? They said, well, they take like a quarter pounder and put guacamole on it. And I said, really? I said, yeah. I said, well, you guys are locals, so put a budget together. And they did, and marketing plans and worked with suppliers and everything else. I think we sold two. Because the locals said, we can get guacamole anywhere. We can get tacos anywhere. Here's what we expect of you at McDonald's. Don't play with it. This is what we expect. We went to Russia. The main reason that people came to visit us in Russia, again, they didn't know who we were and what our menu was. We never ran out of food. At the time we moved into Russia, people always had bags in their hands. You might still see it today, but look at photos of people on the street in Russia. They had bags because they're always running out of things. So if they saw something, they knew that, you know, oranges or bananas or blue jeans or whatever happened to be on sale right now, they'd buy them, but they had their own bag to, you know, carry it around. But they found out, and one of the reasons we moved into Russia and it was so successful, and it still is today, is we brought the equipment over from Canada. By the way, it's Canadian, I'm sure many of you know. It was Canada opened McDonald's in Russia and operated it for many years, because the Americans knew they didn't have the relationship with the Russians. So they called us and said, would you guys go in there, build a relationship, and open restaurants? So that's what we did. But they always knew we wouldn't run out of food, because we brought the equipment over. And so at that time, even getting potatoes out of the fields is all done by hand. And we're talking, you know, late 80s. So we brought the equipment over to do it, and we opened our own food town, we called it, and developed all our products on our own. And because we didn't have that many restaurants at that time, we exported these products into Europe. So we made money off the food town until we had enough restaurants that we could supply ourselves, and then we stopped doing the exporting. So it was, and finally, just to Russia again for a second, when we opened that first restaurant, the president of the country came to the opening and cut the ribbon. And he was handed a Big Mac. But you know what he did? He opened the package up. He started taking it apart, eating the meat patty, eating the bun. We're going, no, that's not how you eat a Big Mac. So we had to go to our crew staff behind the counter and say, now you're also going to have to teach the customer how to eat our food, because they had never eaten it before. So in each country, there's different stories how you relate. In all countries, the biggest thing is trust. They know it's going to be clean, they know the food, they know the menu, they know the pricing. So if they're on a trip and on a holiday, they go, oh, okay, I've had enough of this local food. There's McDonald's, I'm going to go to McDonald's. That's the trust in 118 countries. You were first.
Just to further the cultural differences in these new countries that you moved into, were there any other issues that came out of that, working with local staff as part of your management team, for example? Were there cultural that came out of that? Can you talk to that a little bit?
I'll tell you, the first day. And again, I never spoke the language. My wife's from Quebec. She speaks three languages. I'm the dummy. My kids speak three languages. I only speak English. And when I was in Mexico, they didn't want me to practice the Spanish. You're dealing with millions of dollars. They're saying, we'll figure it out. You just keep speaking English. We'll get an interpreter or whatever. But my first day, I come into the Mexico City downtown offices. And now I'm sitting in there about 7:30, quarter to 8, and there's nobody there. And I'm the new president of McDonald's Mexico. I go, okay, all right, I'll wait around for them to show up. And they started trickling in, and maybe by 10:30, the office started to fill up. So I'm already making my list, right? I said, okay, I know the problem here. I know what they need, right? But they didn't have lunch till 2:30. They didn't have dinner until 8. They didn't leave the office till 7:30, 8 o'clock, and all of a sudden I went, whoa, this is the culture here. They do it a little differently. So I'm not going to change the culture. I could have jumped in real quick, and it would have been a mistake. So you have to, and I always told them I was the visitor. I'm going to be here 4 or 5 years. One of you will replace me. And when I mean one of you, a Mexican. Doesn't mean one of you here. Hopefully it is, but a local will replace me. I replaced an American, great guy. He was a real estate person, and he didn't have an operations background, so that's what was starting to catch up with him. And he stayed with the company. But I just realized very quickly, and I'm glad you asked the question, that you have to be very careful. And the other thing about cultures, I mean, this is a great thing for us Canadians, and an American told me this. I had a visitor one time in the U.S. I think I was there 6 or 7, 8 months. And he said to me, "Are you telling everybody you're Canadian?" I said, "What?" He said, "Are you telling everybody you're Canadian?" I said, no. He said, "Oh, Bill." He said, "If they think you're an American, you're going to have problems. Start telling people," and this guy was brilliant. He said, "Start telling people when you introduce yourself and you're doing talks and whatever, that you're Canadian." And he said, "And call me in 6 months and tell me the difference, the feeling." Huge. You're Canadian. Oh, you're not a gringo. I always thought everybody outside of Mexico was a gringo. It's only Americans. Americans are the gringos. We're Canadians. Canucks.